Hello guys, welcome back to Honest Lifestyle. Well, those who are new here, I'm Khushi and this is Nishant. And I make videos on motivation, parenting and minimalist low-waste lifestyle. So do subscribe for new videos every week. Well, I think aap sabne dekha hoga, hamara ghar abhi ki situation mein hai. So a lot of you guys ask and a lot of my family members and friends ask ki how we, you know, take care of a baby alone. I mean, it's said that it takes a village to take care of a baby or of a child. We need an entire village or army of people. However, we just stay alone here. And he's up. So let's see how the video goes. He hardly slept for a while and we thought we'll try to, you know, shoot the video. But it's okay. The more the merrier. So we are often asked how we, you know, take care of the baby. All by ourselves. We just wanted to share what it has been for us, how the experience has been. It is daunting a lot of times. It's fun, it's loving, it's I don't know, it's exhausting, tiring. So the thing is, I had my delivery in Mumbai. Mumbai mein hamare in-laws rehte hain. And Varanasi mein my parents are there. So basically after 2 months, I think the day he was 2 months old, we came back to Bangalore. So other than that, we have been doing everything by ourselves. Iski massage karni ho, malish, you know, nehlana wagera, everything. So what we do is, the first thing that you have to acknowledge is that your baby is your full-time responsibility. So I'm not saying that you need to leave your career or anything of that sort. It's definitely a person's personal opinion and personal choice. So in my case, mein kya tha? We did not have any you know, support system here in Bangalore. And I was not mentally and physically ready to leave him in a creche or with someone I don't know completely, you know, for that long duration. I couldn't get that many work from home months. So that is one thing. That's when I decided to resign. And he's so happy. And I decided to look after him initially. Yes. And the second thing that we have to acknowledge is that, you know, if you are going out for a job, that is perfectly fine, good for you. If you can leave your baby with someone you trust, or you have your in-laws or your parents to look after them, then that's wonderful. I mean, that's really awesome.
I think the important part is that you have someone you can trust. Aww. And your baby is safe and you are at mental peace that wherever your baby is, he's comfortable, he's at the right place and
with the right people.
He's being nurtured well.
Yeah. So another important fact is that it's not just a mother's responsibility to look after the baby. It's definitely father's responsibility as well. I mean, we are in the times where you are allowed to cut baby's umbilical cord. So Nishant ne khud Gudda ka umbilical cord cut kiya tha when he was born. Yes, yes, we'll tell that story. Yes, we are going to. So Gudda ka umbilical cord cut kiya tha, and so they have to be involved equally. I mean, obviously mom ka zyada hak hota hai and baby zyada attached hota hai. Haan, but still Nishant helps me with all kinds of things. So agar when he is in office, subah se shaam tak diapers main change karti hu, and once he's back, diaper changing responsibility is all his. And I think weekends go right. Monday to Friday, I give him massage and I bathe him. Kya ho gaya?
So,
And Friday ke baad, jab, you know, on weekends, Nishant uski malish karte hain and he gives him a bath. Okay, you know what? He's very cranky. We'll be right back. So guys, this is what he's doing right now. Hopefully he'll remain in a playful mood for 5-10 minutes. Let's see how that goes. Yeah, so what I was telling was ki, you know, equal responsible. I actually have forgotten what I was talking about. Yes. So it's equal responsibility of both parents.
Weekend main. Weekends main responsibility. That's what
you were saying. Yeah. So weekends mein mostly inki responsibility hoti hai. He looks after him. And that's when I do a proper breakfast, lunch, dinner. I make all of those things. Otherwise, weekdays mein mostly mera breakfast skip ho jata hai. But however, you should not do that because it's not good for your health. Or to all the ladies out there, especially, please don't do that.
Mera office se aake pehla kaam hota hai ki Buddha ke saath main pehle ice spice khelta hu. Because he's very happy to see me and he still wants me. So मैं पहले उसके साथ हाइड एंड सीक खेलता हूँ. हम लोग पिकअपू खेलते हैं, हम लोग जहाँ जहाँ खेलते हैं. आई जस्ट क्रॉल अंडर हिज चेयर. वो फिर चेयर से कूद कूद के देखता है. इफ ही इज नॉट सिटिंग ऑन अ चेयर ऑन हिज फीडिंग चेयर, वो अगर कहीं बैठा है या कहीं लेटा है, ही जस्ट स्टार्ट रनिंग टूवर्ड्स मी. ही इज सो हैप्पी टू सी मी एंड आई एम इक्वली हैप्पी टू सी हिम. एंड आई थिंक हम दोनों को छोड़ के खुशी ज्यादा हैप्पी होती है क्योंकि अब उसको डायपर नहीं बदलना होगा. बट हाँ, उसकी दूसरी भी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज होती हैं. उसको खाना पकाना है, उसको और भी चीजें देखनी
है. द थिंग इज, हमने कुक या कोई केयरगिवर, सोना कोई केयरगिवर नहीं रखा है. However, we are planning to keep one now क्योंकि जैसे जैसे ये बड़ा हो रहा है, घर में इधर उधर भागता है, तो it becomes quite difficult उसको देखने के साथ, you know, to cook and to do laundry and all of those things. So let's see how that goes. Okay, he wants to go on the floor. So another thing that I want to say is कि जैसे अभी मैंने आपको दिखाया, right? The place is a mess right now. हमारे घर में काफी चीजें फैली हुई हैं, तो please don't take a lot of stress. आई यूज टू डू दैट अ लॉट. मुझे बहुत लगता था कि हमारा घर बहुत गंदा है या यू नो बहुत ज्यादा मेस्ड अप है. एंड इट्स ओके बिकॉज बेबी के आने के बाद थिंग्स चेंज. यू कैन नॉट ऑलवेज कीप इट यू नो क्लीन ऑल द टाइम बिकॉज आपका घर इज नॉट आउट ऑफ दोज मैगजीन कवर्स. इट्स अ होम फिल्ड विद लव, लाफ्टर एंड मेस. तो वॉट आई डिड वॉज, इंस्टेड ऑफ ऑलवेज ट्राइंग टू क्लीन इट अप, आई स्टार्टेड मिनिमाइजिंग थिंग्स सो दैट देर बी लेस ऑफ थिंग्स टू क्लीन. In fact, I have a whole series on minimalism which I'm trying to do. More videos will be out soon.
So yes. I think the mess is the byproduct of love and laughter. So
yeah.
if you perceive it that way, perceive it that way.
It will make your life simpler. There are days, I mean, when I try to clean up everything before, you know, going to bed or when I get up first thing in the morning. And there are days where, you know, we just order food from outside and we are like, just, you know, call it a day. We don't do any cleaning, nothing. The mess is there. We handle it the next day. So it's okay. And especially to the moms out there, please don't think that, you know, people are judging you or anything of that sort. Because it's your life, your home, your baby. At the end of the day, all that matters is how you brought them up, how you brought your baby up. So Nishant is handling him. I'll just try to tell you a few more things. So to all the ladies out there especially, it's okay to, you know, just let it be for a time being. When you feel like that, when you feel claustrophobic or something like that, just take deep breaths. I have suffered a lot because of this, because I have always been, you know, kind of perfectionist in certain things, which cannot happen now basically because it's not possible all the time. So I've learned to live with it. Another important thing when you are looking after your baby alone is that, you know, just try to make routine, if it's possible, proper routine for baby, you know, bathing time or be it massage time. I know it's not always possible, but still, just try to follow some kind of pattern or routine so that it will be easier for you and you'll be less lost. And again, try to steal some time for yourself, because we tend to just give all our energy in and then later we end up tired. It has happened with me. And it's certainly not a good experience, and you definitely, that, you know, that's one of the major reasons why women slip into the postpartum depression. I will talk about that soon in my another video. I have a whole story of the depression phase and it was a roller coaster ride, so I will definitely share it with the hope that it will help a lot of people out there. Other important thing is, everybody says that sleep when your baby sleeps. I don't think that works out all the time because it has not personally worked out for me a lot of times. You cannot always sleep when the baby sleeps because in the beginning babies sleep every 1.5 hours for 1.5, 2 hours. So what I would do is when he used to sleep, I used to, you know, have my lunch or breakfast or whatever it is and, you know, try to finish up the chores of the house because I didn't have a lot of help. I don't have even now. So, but, you know, do those things and then sleep when, you know, in the afternoon or in the night when you get some time, or maybe hand over your baby to your husband once he comes home, and then you can sleep for a while or take a quiet nap or something like that. That is what worked out for me, at least. And another thing that I would like to tell is ki, it's okay not if you're, you know, if you're not able to cook all the time. There are a lot of safe, healthy options out there even when you're breastfeeding or, you know, even when you are not well to eat. Because trying to prepare a homemade meal for yourself or your husband can be very daunting. So just pick out, like we have 2-3 restaurants where, you know, which is our go-to place if we are very tired or if it's very exhausting. And we know the food quality is good and we know it's safe and healthy to eat. So just keep that also in mind. The other thing is that to make your life simpler with the baby, if you're alone, is that designate one particular place for everything. Like keep your baby's essentials always in that particular place, so that when you are alone and your husband is in the office, you don't go running here and there, you know, leaving the baby alone and trying to find out ki ye cheez kahan rakh di maine, cream nahi mil rahi hai ya comb nahi mil raha hai ya diaper sheet nahi mil rahi hai. So what I do is I always keep it beside my bed, most of the essential things. I even keep all his clothes in the cupboard, right in our bedroom. I have changed my entire bedroom after he was born, so that, you know, it would be easier for me to grab things when I need. That is another suggestion which you should follow. And I would suggest invest in a playpen. I regret it a lot why I didn't do this earlier. I mean, it's a great option. I would not be able to, you know, run to the washroom at times because I was alone and I was so scared to leave him, you know, in a safe, secure place. Even though we have those bed railings in the bed, but still from the time he started crawling and all, it was difficult to leave him and go. I have taken shower at 8 o'clock in the night. I mean, I have done all those things because I just couldn't leave him alone and, you know, go and take a bath. But with the playpen, I mean, it's very safe and secure. You can leave your baby and at least, you know, do basic things which you need to do, maybe brush your teeth and things like that. So that is another important thing. Invest in baby safety essentials so that they come in handy when you are alone. If you want, you can even go for baby monitor or a baby camera. I mean, but I didn't go for it, however, but you can definitely try. Or dusri cheez, ek aur baat ye hai ki what you can try is what you're cooking, cook for yourself as well as the baby. So it will be helpful. Like ab jab ghar pe akele ho, to it's not really possible jab aapka baby solid food pe aata hai ki, you know, aap uske liye alag cheez banao and then khud ke liye alag banao and just for one person you cook and eat. It becomes very difficult. There have been days when I've not eaten for the same reason. So what you do is you try to shift your baby to family meal as soon as possible, because Varu has been on family meal ever since, I think, 7-8 months, and it's what doctors and it's what WHO recommends. In fact, I have a video on that how you should, you know, start solid food for your baby and what food you should include based on WHO and other research guidelines. You can see it probably in the description box or in the suggested videos. Somewhere this side or this side, I'm always confused. So yeah, you can see that and you can watch that later. It will be very helpful. Now, when you feel sad and depressed and lonely, or you feel that you have, you know, your hands are all full with all sorts of things, just stop. Pause and let everything be as it is for 1 hour, 1 hour. Just go out, breathe in fresh air. Trust me, it has happened with me. So you got to do it. Don't, you know, be too harsh on yourself. That is where, you know, the depression kicks in and it takes over us. So, however, I will talk about this in detail, but yeah, just give yourself a break. Just leave whatever it is and however it is, and then you can resume it later. You can always resume than going, you know, crazy about it. So, Yeah, and just be easy about it. It's just initial, you know, 1.5 years of your life where you have to manage and, you know, look after things in a different way. And but, you know, with all the madness that's going around in my life, in Nishant's life, you know, in our family, that one smile which Varu gives us at the end of the day or even in between, that one hug, that one kissy which he does, it makes all the difference in the world. I mean, I am ready to do it all over again for him the next moment. So, you know, that is something which keeps me going, and I'm sure that is something which keeps all the moms going, because we are such strong-willed women, such strong-willed girls, that we can do anything. And all we ask and seek for is a little support from our husbands, or, you know, maybe if you are with your in-laws, with your parents, that's all we need. And some time off to get our, you know, mind in the right place. And by time off, I don't even mean that, you know, we don't want to take responsibility of the child. It's just that we need support and care, someone showering love on us as well, or someone pampering us. That's all we need. So yeah, these are not the regular tips or the suggestions which you get from other people out there, but this is what I feel ladies need to know more than if I would tell, you know, get up at 6 o'clock in the morning and at 10 o'clock you feed your baby or something like that. I think this will help you probably better, because it has helped me. I'm telling you from my own mistakes what I have done, or something that has worked out for me. So yeah, this is what we have to say to you guys as a family, and this is what we have been following. And among all the craziness, we are a sweet loving family, and we fight. I mean, there have been instances I fought with Nishant, he has fought with me, but we always come back. Yeah, and Varu has fought with me, but we always, you know, find our way into each other's heart every time. And just be yourself, be happy, don't think too much about the society, about your neighbors, about what the world would think. No one is perfect, and we are all trying to raise our babies the best way we can.
I want to reach out to all the husbands, since Khushi is reaching out to all the moms. I think I should reach out to all the fathers. I know we have our careers, we have our jobs, but family is always important. And give time to your family, give time to your child, play with them, play with your family, be with your family. Help your wives as much as you can, because they do run everything. Most of the times they run the show, but
sometimes it's good to give them a break and take charge.
Yeah, so take lead for the house sometimes. Give them a break maybe, and I think that's all I have to say. It's a beautiful journey we are going through, and hope you are also enjoying your parenting days, and happy parenting.
Yeah, it's the most beautiful part you will ever come across in your life. Just enjoy it and let things be as they are for a while, and just, you know, be with your baby and give them all the love and care they need. If you did like our video, please give it a big thumbs up. Share it with your friends and family who are in need of such hatke advices. Do subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for more videos on baby care, motivation, and minimalist, low-waste lifestyle. Say bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Okay, that side. Don't do that. Don't do this. Okay. Don't you say it tilted? Huh?